Okay, let's unpack this. So this deep dive is really for you, the listener. Maybe you want the power of some of this new tech AI stuff, but you don't have a computer science degree, right?
Exactly. Our goal today was to find tools that are genuinely easy. We looked for free, open source options that do cool things like summarizing or writing help, but are built for, you know, everyday life.
Yeah, like for parents, students, office workers.
Yeah.
Anyone who just needs things to be simple, fast, no confusing jargon.
And the big idea that jumped out from the sources is that these smaller local AI tools are finally making powerful tech accessible without the complexity. They really tackle those common daily hassles. And importantly, they save you money, zero subscription fees, and they keep your stuff private because it all runs right there on your own computer.
That privacy part is huge. Okay, so let's start with one called Handy. This one tackles dictation, speech to text.
Right. And what's cool here is it's free, works on different systems, okay. You know, Windows, Mac, and it works completely offline.
Offline. So my voice isn't going to the cloud or anything?
Right. Nope. Total privacy. You just talk, hit a keyboard shortcut, and bam, words pop up instantly, like right inside whatever program you're using. An email, a document, notes, anything with a text box.
Okay. I've tried dictation before, honestly, and it always seemed a bit clunky, especially with names or specific terms. Is this actually better?
Well, the focus here is on these newer, really efficient models that can run locally without needing giant servers. So you get the speed, but also that privacy. Your voice just stays put.
Okay, that's definitely appealing. No cloud needed.
Exactly. And building on that idea of local help, there's another tool called Everywhere.
Everywhere. So it helps you. Everywhere. On your computer.
Sort of, yeah. It's context aware. It understands what you're actually looking at on your screen at that moment.
Oh, interesting. So I don't need to, like, copy and paste text into a separate AI window.
Right. No switching apps. Say you hit some weird error message pop-up. You can just trigger Everywhere right next to it, and it could suggest a fix. Or maybe you've got a super long web page open. Ask Everywhere for, say, a quick three-point summary. Or you wrote a quick email draft and you think, oh, this needs polishing. Tell Everywhere, make this sound more professional. Right there.
That sounds incredibly useful. Just instant help right where you need it.
Mm-hmm. Private, instant assistance based on what you're doing.
Okay, that leads nicely into managing, well, lots of private information. Like all those documents we have piling up. Is there something for that?
There is. It's called Anything LLM. Think of it like building your own private AI library.
A private library? How does that work? Is it complicated?
No, that's the key. The sources really emphasize the zero code part. You just download the app Windows, Mac, Linux, and start adding your documents.
What kind of documents? PDFs?
Word logs. Yep. PDFs, Word files, text notes, pretty much anything. You're basically feeding it your own information, teaching your own private AI assistant.
So then I can talk to my documents, ask them questions.
Precisely. You chat with your whole collection using normal language. You could ask, what are the key terms in this rental agreement? Or maybe summarize my meeting notes from last Tuesday. Or even find all the deadlines mentioned in my travel plans.
And because it's running on my computer.
All that sensitive data, personal finances, maybe health records, contracts, and never leaves your device. Total control, total privacy.
That's a big deal. Okay, let's switch gears a bit. It's not all just text and documents, right? What about creative stuff, like music?
Right. For music lovers or maybe people who want to make karaoke tracks, there's a tool called Ultimate Vocal Remover, UVR.
Ultimate Vocal Remover. Does what it says on the tin, I guess.
Pretty much. It uses some quite advanced AI tech, but the interface is just a straightforward desktop app. You feed it an audio file, and it separates the singing from the music.
So you can get just the instrumental track.
Yep.
Or just the vocals.
Exactly. Great for making backing tracks, or maybe isolating a voice recording to clean it up if there's background noise you want to get rid of. Simple interface, powerful result.
Okay, one last tool. A prompt optimizer. Now, if these AI tools are getting so good, why do I need to optimize my instructions, my prompt?
That's a good question. It's because, well, even powerful AI doesn't know your exact intention, right? It doesn't have your real-world context. Getting really high-quality results, especially for writing tasks like emails or reports, often means being quite precise with what you ask for.
Ah, so it helps you phrase your request better.
Yeah, it helps bridge that gap between a vague request like write an email and something specific like draft a polite but firm email to my colleague about the project deadline, referencing the discussion we had yesterday. Precision in, better quality out, helps make the AI output more stable and useful for what you actually need.
Okay, so pulling this all together, what we're seeing is that really advanced AI power summarization, dictation, analyzing your own documents, even audio stuff, it's being packaged up in ways that are genuinely easy to use.
And free. Free, simple desktop tools that focus on keeping your data private right on your own machine.
You get the AI benefits without the monthly fees, and crucially, without handing over all your personal info to some giant company's cloud.
Exactly. The power without the usual trade-offs.
So the big hurdle for a lot of people, myself included sometimes, is just trying something new, right? Taking that first step. So thinking about these tools, simple installation, runs locally, keeps things private. Here's something for you, the listener, to consider. What's the one daily task, that one annoying chore or information lookup you do, maybe something you currently copy-paste into a public website? What's the one thing you might finally be ready to hand over to a free private AI assistant running safely on your own computer?